Sports Locker Sunday, presented by Old National Bank, starts now.
Oh, man, what a day for your Indianapolis Colts. The ultimate, collapse here down in Jacksonville as the Colts are sent home and done for the season. Hi, everybody. Good evening to you and welcome live to Sports Locker Sunday. I'm Anthony Calhoun. I know Colts fans, you're saying to yourself tonight, what in the world happened to your football team? Here to help me break it all down here tonight on Sports Locker Sunday. You guys know the face, Charlie Clifford. 2-14, my friend, Jacksonville. They have owned the Colts for so many years down there in Florida, but no way they're going to take care of business today against a Colts team that at 1.3 weeks ago was a team that nobody wanted to see in the playoffs.
Right.
But now they're not going to see them literally because they're not going to the postseason.
AC, the most disappointing loss in Colts regular season history. It's the low point of the Ballard Reich regime. If you take Andrew Luck's retirement out of the picture, and the center of this question tonight is, we were sold this offseason that the marriage between Frank Reich and Carson Wentz was going to bring a prolific passing offense back to Indianapolis. They were going to take a step forward from the wild card loss last year to Buffalo. And that didn't happen. And it's a complicated answer that I think we need to break down tonight, because I know Carson Wentz is going to get 99.9% of the heat. It's much deeper than that.
Yeah, it is. And, you know, we're going to get to the highlights in a moment. But when I look at what transpired today with this football team, our producer, Ross Boland, we talked about this on our postgame show as well. You know, it's all about how you start these games. And the Colts have started off very well the past few weeks. And then I should take it back. Last week was a tough week against the Raiders. But throughout the season, they start off pretty well. Then the past few weeks, it got challenging for this team. At the start of the game, the Colts chose to defer the football and take in the second half. I felt like you saw your offense struggling last week. You're going against a team 2-14. The last thing you want to do is give this rookie quarterback any type of confidence if they score on the touchdown. Well, look what happened. They drive it 7 minutes there on that first drive for the Raiders. Get the touchdown, right? You got your offense, Carson Wentz, sitting still until 8 minutes to start in that first quarter, you think about it. And then, of course, they go, what, three and out. To me, I felt like setting the tone early was important for this team, and obviously that did not happen here against the Jaguars today.
That was a play not to lose move.
Yeah.
I think that was a reoccurring theme, not only last week but this week, AC. It is a nightmare that won't be erased tomorrow, this week, next month. We're going to have to hear about these questions all the way up until training camp. And I know no one in Indy enjoys this conversation.
Yeah, you know, and we talked about just here's our city in Indianapolis getting ready for the biggest night in college football tomorrow. And here we are talking about a Colts loss, a team that should be making their way of really sitting back at home tonight, relaxing and going to the postseason. But that is not going to be the case.